Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to implement Caesar Cipher in Java. So what is Caesar Cipher? Well, Caesar Cipher is one of the earliest known and simplest ciphers. It is a type of substitution cipher in which each letter in the plain text is shifted a certain number of places down the alphabet. In this example, for shift of 3, A letter would become letter D, and letter B would become letter E, letter C would become letter F, and so on. So this method is named after Julius Caesar, who apparently used it to communicate with his generals. And the Caesar cipher offers essentially no communication security, and it can be easily broken by hand, but it is interesting to implement this method in Java, just for fun. Well, let's say we have this text, and the text says attack at dawn. So this is a message that Julius Caesar sent to his general. And let's say we want to shift this message by 2. So each letter in this message, in this plain text, is shifted by 2 down the alphabet. So letter A becomes C, letter T becomes we, and so on. So this plain message becomes this ciphertext. Okay? Now I have already created this Caesar package in the ciphers project, so I will create inside of it a new class and I will call it Caesar. Okay, and we will have this main method inside of it. Okay, and first we will create the method for text encryption. So remember that this method will only shift letters, and the numbers and the other symbols will not be shifted. So only letters and only English alphabet letters. There are other ways to do this by taking your own alphabet and creating a string from your alphabet and then doing encryption using it, but this is using English alphabet. So public static string, and let's call it encrypt, and it will have two parameters. First parameter will be string plain text, and the second will be the shift, so it will be an integer. So the shift is really a key for decryption and encryption. Now after this, we need to make sure that the shift, the number, must be between 0 and 26. So you say, why 26? Well, English alphabet has 26 letters, and they do not have a negative, of course. So we need to create, if the user puts here the negative number or a number greater than 26, we need to reduce it somewhere between 0 and 26. And we need it to do it right. So we need an if-else statement. So if shift is greater than 26, well then shift becomes shift modulus 26. Okay, and else if shift is less than 0, so if shift is negative, shift is equal to, and we'll say again, shift modulus 26, but plus 26 at the end. So this here, this piece of code will take the integer of shift variable, and if it is greater than 26, it will place it somewhere between 0 and 26. And if it is less than 0, it will also place it somewhere between 0 and 26. So now that we have done this, we will write our new string called ciphertext. And for now, this will be an empty string, and this will be our return value. So we can write immediately return ciphertext. And between this, we need to get the length of the plain text. So integer length is equal to plain text length. Okay. Now the last thing to do is to loop through this string plain text and shift every letter, every character inside of it, and assign that character to this ciphertext string. So now after this, we will write the for loop, integer I is equal 0, I is less than length, and I plus plus. Okay. Now in this for loop, we will take the character at the index of I every time. So char ch is equal to plain text char at I. Okay. Now remember, we only shift letters and we are not interested in any other things. So symbols, numbers will not be shifted. So we need to check if this character is letter. So if character is letter and we place ch as a parameter, then we'll do something, and else we will just add this ch character to the ciphertext string. So ciphertext plus equals ch, and that is it. And now inside of this if statement, we will need another if statement. Well, we'll need to check if the letter or this character is uppercase or lowercase. Why is that? Well, we will need the integer value of each character, because this integer value of the character represents a value from the ASCII table that we will use to shift our characters. So I have a picture of ASCII table, and as you can see, every character has its own decimal, hexadecimal, octal, and so on value. So the decimal values of uppercase letters are in range from 65 to 90, and of lowercase letters are in range of 97 to 122. So if statement, character is lowercase, then we pass this ch char, and else if character is uppercase and ch as a parameter. So if character is lowercase, then we'll do next. So we'll make the new shifted character, so char c is equal to, and now we must add our shift to the integer value of this ch. So ch plus shift, but as we can see, this gives us an error, so we must cast the result of this to a character. So let's place this between parentheses, and at the beginning we will just write char and use parentheses to do casting. Okay, so this new character C becomes shift the character of the character ch. And if this character is out of bounds, well, what does it mean? So if we had, for example, a letter x and we had a shift of 6, so add this 6 to 88 and you will get 94, and you will get this symbol, and we do not want any symbol, we want any of uppercase letters. So we will need, if it is out of bounds, it will just go at the beginning and loop again and again until it finds the suitable letter. So if C, the new character, is greater than Z, the last character in the ASCII alphabet, then ciphertext plus equals, and now we'll do some math. So ch, integer value of ch, minus, then parentheses 26 minus shift. Okay, now to cast this, we need to first place this between parentheses, all of this, and then cast this by writing char, okay, and semicolon at the end, and now we have the new character that will be added to ciphertext string. But if the character is not out of bounds, so else ciphertext plus equals C. Okay, now we can copy just this, okay, copy this piece of code and just place it in the else if character is uppercase, and in here we'll just change this lowercase z to uppercase z, and that is it. Now this is a complete method for Caesar cipher. Okay, now in our main method we will create string, we will call it text, and the string will become some message like this is some message, and the new string cipher is equal to encrypt, and we'll place text as a parameter and a shift of, let's say, 5. Okay, and now let's print this out. So system out print line, and we'll print cipher string, save, run, and we will get this uncomprehensive message. So now we need some decryption method to decrypt this message. Okay, and now that we have our encrypt method, so now we just have to copy this encrypt method. So copy this, paste it beneath, change the name to decrypt, and we will make just a few slight changes to this method so it could work, so it could do in reverse, decrypt the message. So first change is, instead of plus shift here, put minus shift. Instead of C greater than Z, put C less than lowercase a. Then change this minus to plus. Then do exactly the same in the else if statement, so ch minus shift c less than uppercase a and ch plus, and save it. So now to test this decrypt method, we will create new string, call it decrypted, and it is equal to the return value of this decrypt message, and place cipher as a parameter, and second parameter will be number 5. That will be number of shifts. So copy this system out print line, and instead of cipher we will print decrypted. Okay, save it, run it, and we get encrypted message and a decrypted message. So this is all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.